This is a Duracell My Pocket Charger. This is an older one. I got this from Costco. She's about 7 or 8 years ago. And I only use it a few times, and it would only bring an iPod Touch from low to dead to maybe 20, 25, 30, 30%. And my iPhone now, I've tried it, and it's hard for me to waste batteries like that. So this to me is not really a great idea. So how it works is you put two batteries in there, and you plug this into there, and you know the Apple always has to, Apple products have to have that extra circuit other than just a regular old USB, positive and negative. You have to have some sort of 100 ohm resistor off the positive on the data cables, but all that happens inside this little thing right here, which makes it really nice. And in fact, when I bought this at Costco, I got two of them and two sets of these plugs. So I went ahead and sliced one up, and I sliced up the plug first, and I made this. So this is just USB male, and then the iPod with all the stuff in there, so I could charge any iPods, including iPads that use that kind of a cord, in any USB situation. So. And then I took the other thing that, see, these came with two for $20, this whole set and another whole set. So I took another one, and here it is, same thing. But I cut it off, and get this out of the way. And I hot glued it to a 3.7-volt 4,400 milliamp lithium-ion battery, and that powers this thing, and then I put a controller on it, a lithium-ion controller, and I put some hot glue all over the connection so nothing gets accidentally touched. Now let me plug this in. There, that's plugged in. See the green? That means that it's ready to go. I can't plug in my iPhone because that's what I'm taking the video with. But anyway. This will charge my iPhone 3.5 times, 3.75 times, and which that's more than enough to take on a camping trip or something. So I just use this as a battery bank, and then I have now for charging in the sunlight, which I'm obsessed with. I took this. This is a military something. It's got, I don't know if this is actual Molly attachments on the back, but I bent up this piece of coat hanger and made it so that it's like a belt hoop, so you can put it on your belt. Now this is a battery bank. It takes four of those 18650 laptop cells that I got them out of a laptop battery that I had years ago, and this. I need two hands. Come on. Okay. This I made, that goes in a little case. Yeah, I went crazy with some duct tape here after seeing a Big Monkey One's video on making a sheath, a duct tape sheath. So I just decided to make this, not to be competitive or anything, just because I was gonna make it make a fold out solar cell out of jean material that I had all cut up, and then I saw his video and I was like, you know what, it'd be a lot easier, and then I don't have to do a lot of sewing. I don't have a sewing machine or even access to one. But there's three cells, 1, 2, 3. These are each six volts, 167 milliamps each, 1 watt each. So this is like 3 watts, 6 volts. It's all in parallel, and 501 milliamps roughly. There's a blocking diode on one of the cells. All of them are wired to that one cell, and then the blocking diode coming out so that electricity can't go back into the panels, and that lowers the voltage and probably the milliamps just a little bit. But so just set this in the sun, plug this in right here, and it does charge. I'll show you. There is a red light that comes on when it's getting enough. This is just a 40 watt lamp. See this lamp there, 40 watt bulb, and it's showing that it's getting some electricity into this. So that doesn't mean that it's actually charging. It just means that there's some voltage present. So this, fold it right back up. I can take that off too. I just attached it on there because I was just making a huge project. I don't know. I was just going crazy with it. But all self-contained. You put that underneath there. And then it goes in this, or just throw it in your pocket, whatever. And this, I can plug this into to charge it. So charge this while I'm out wherever, camping, and charge this. And I can charge this while this is charging. I've already done that. And this puts out 500 milliamps. It'll charge this thing in probably 9 hours, 8 hours, so 2 days of full-blown sunlight will be fully charged. And it has this red light turns green when it's charged, so that'll let me know. But I don't know, I keep on ripping stuff apart and making other stuff, but that's where I'm at now. I think this is pretty neat. This is cool. It's so small, and it fits in this phone case that I had from my old phone long, long time ago. And there's plenty of room left. I just stuffed the cords in there. And that way I'm not wasting batteries. And I can't stand using batteries. And then they go dead. And then you got to throw them away. It's not that I'm obsessed with the environment and not throwing away batteries. I mean, that is part of it. But I'm obsessed with not spending money on something that you can only use once and throw away when the rechargeable batteries are not much more money. Rechargeable nickel metal hydride batteries like these, I bought 4 of these, and they're 250 milliamps at Radio Shack. I bought them for $17. Now, 4 AA's are going to be like $10. So for the price, you pay double. And then you can use them for 500 times and recharge them. You can use solar to recharge them, and that's saving you money. So there's all kinds of ways to save money. And there's all kinds of things that I'm going to be obsessed with. Right now, this is it. So leave a comment, subscribe, post a video response or something. Let's get a conversation going. I love talking about solar and solar-powered stuff and battery banks and recharging and charging and survival stuff. So leave a comment. Thank you.